9 out of 10 times, bash scripts are just a pile of entangled scripts. It's missing input validation, makeshift functions, if those exist at all, and lack any kind of separation. Beyond bugs and the many fixes it requires, it's a lot of times just a frustrating codebase to maintain. So today I want to share with you a framework exactly targeting this issue, a bash CLI framework called Bashly. Bashly is a framework that comes with a command line. It's very customizable. It helps generating easy to maintain, easy to read, and robust shell scripts. It'll take care of the environment variables, arguments, flags, input validation, even tests. So you can handle your bash scripts like a professional, just as you would with any other language. So today I want to build a simple command line tool that scans all of the AWS regions for EC2 instances and report how many of them are running. I'll tweak it by adding the option to eliminate the region I'm currently working on to filter only real resources. We start off with Bashly init. You can add the dash dash minimal flag if you want to create a shorter one. This will create a boilerplate on which you can run Bashly generate, and that will take the YAML configuration and turn it into an executable script. Let's review what was created. During the init process, it created a configuration file, and that states a name, a version, the tool's commands, the argument, flags, and so on. Read the docs on the website for a full description, although what you see here pretty much covers what you need to know. I'm going to rename the tool and remove whatever parts I don't currently need. The plan I have is to accept any AWS service as an argument. I will only apply the EC2 logic for the purpose of this video, but the idea is to be able to serve all other services. So I'll go ahead and remove the environment variables and then configure my command. The first command and the only one that I'll implement is the scan command. I can add an alias, which will be a shortcut, and then add a helpful description for the user when they print the help. Since I'm working in a specific region, I'd also like to add an exclude flag to my command. This will help me filter only the regions that I'm not currently working in and are actually running resources that I'm paying for and I didn't intend to. I'll rename the tool to SAWS, just so it's easier to run here. In Bashly, every YAML configuration changes require to run Bashly generate to update the codebase. Once they're generated, we can see the tool tells us what was created. And if we try to print the tree, we can see all the new commands that are sitting under SRC. And there is one executable, in this case too, in the root of the project. I'll remove the old files and get going with implementing the logic. Let's start building the tool. To open my command, I'm going to find the scan command that was generated based on the YAML configuration. To read a Bashly argument, all I have to do is read it from the args in Bash. This is quite similar with flags, only adding the dash dash before the name of the variable. You can, by the way, configure either of them as optional or mandatory. I'd like to get all regions from AWS API. I'm going to use JQ to help filter them out. FZF can help filter out the excluded region. If you're unfamiliar with FZF, check out my terminal setup video, specifically the FZF chapter that starts at the 6th minute. I'm going to link to them both up here above in the video. See what happens when I pipe the result to FZF. The user can now interactively choose a region. That's amazing. FZF also allows for multiple choice, but I'll avoid the complication for now. I will now move on to implementing the logic that finds the instances on AWS using the AWS CLI. If you notice the diagnostics warnings here, these come from Bash LSP with NeoVim and ShellCheck. See the link above for my video covering these. Okay, the tool seems to be doing its job. I can see a list of the regions from AWS, followed by the number of instances that are currently running. So I'm pretty happy about that. Let's see if the filter works. Here's FZF popping with all the available regions where I can choose one. I can use FZF's fuzzy search to find US West 2, where I'm currently running. My chosen region is left untouched and I get a summary of instances from all others. Bashly add lib helps here by creating a file where I can hold utility functions. For example, let's add a utility that prints the region I'm working with and call it from within the original command. I'm going back to the scan command and quickly adding a line that prints the utility function I just created in the lib directory. I'm running bashly generate again, and the script is running. Let's see if it prints the output for the current region. There it is, the default region is EU West 1. Now that we have everything working, let's open the generate code and see what it stores and why is it so powerful. I'm going to open the SAWS, the executable file that Bashly created. There's a usage function that prints a helpful message with all the subcommands, the arguments, flags, and instructions. Next comes input normalization, where uppercases and strange characters are handled for us using pattern matching. Then comes the logic we implemented, followed by argument parsers, initialization function, and the process handler. All of these are keeping you from falling into the known pitfalls of wild scripts and no standards. Personally, I've moved to using Bashly with all my Bash tools. Just like when I run Cobra for Golang-based CLIs, I want my Bash code to be as robust as possible, and Bashly does all the heavy lifting for me. If you enjoyed this video, check out my Bash flow and how I configure the LSP to work with NeoVim. See you on the next one.